O&M stands for operations and maintenance. Another term for it would be asset management. O&M is about making sure that the system is operating safely and performing to spec. There are many different ways that O&M providers can provide services. We're going to cover the majority of those. O&M can include any of the following services: vegetation management to ensure that there's no shading, wildlife prevention and animal damage, rainwater runoff and erosion management, roof inspections, upkeep of monitoring systems, detailed review of all electrical connections, cleaning and preventative maintenance on inverter cabinets, IV curve tracing, insulation resistance testing, reactive repair, equipment replacement, and warranty enforcement, and finally reporting site information to the system owner. There are lots of reasons why a system owner would engage an O&M provider. O&M is primarily a mitigation strategy to keep down the cost of unforeseen problems. We all know things break down over time. Engaging an O&M contractor is a way for a system owner to ensure that they have somebody to call when and if something breaks down. Often an O&M provider will include an on-call troubleshooting service. O&M is usually applied only to larger systems. Small to mid-sized systems typically use more of a trending method. A trending report is typically done by the system owner. A system owner will typically go down on a daily basis and record the instantaneous output at the same time of day and on a weekly or monthly basis, total kWh produced for that time period. They use that data to look for anomalies such as low or high production values. A trending report is not as useful on a larger system due to the complexity of those systems, and typically there's enough money in the project to pay for a third-party O&M provider. My experience has been that O&M works for systems of about 500 kW or larger, or for system owners who own a portfolio of projects, some of which may be smaller than 500 kW. With systems this size, owners contract O&M providers to provide three main things. First, and the most important thing to a system owner should be the safety of the system. Specifically, the important things are protecting the building or property against damage from shorts or potential fire hazards, and also preventing personnel from being shocked or electrocuted. Second, owners need a regular review of the general site conditions. This means looking at every detail in the system. Third, and this is the biggest economic reason, system owners want to verify the production of their system. Is the array performing up to specs? And if not, why? Long term, there are production problems you cannot catch with array level data that you can catch with O&M. For instance, this would allow system owners to catch module failures and warranty issues much faster than otherwise possible. On some projects, there's a contractual obligation built in to verify production. Beyond a system owner wanting an O&M contract, there may be third parties that require it, such as financiers and insurance companies. O&M is a very attractive service for providers to add to their suite of services. From the provider's side, O&M is a steady reoccurring revenue stream, which is important with all the volatility in the PV industry. There are two basic models for providing O&M service. In the traditional model, O&M providers would include maintenance services at an hourly rate. Another model would include just providing a prescription for services. Those services would then be put out to bid or researched further by the system owner. In this video series, we are going to portray the second option. Consider this video a case study on how one O&M provider delivers services to a customer. We'll start with O&M agreements, information gathering from the customer, and plan preparation. Then we'll take a close look at the on-site visit, including a visual assessment, IR thermography of crucial components, IV curve tracing, and the completion of a field report. Finally, we'll go through the process of reporting the O&M findings to the customer.